Welcome, friends, to another edition of Tiffin Cast. My name is Seishu, and today I am really being honored by speaking to Susan Stripling Mautner, who is a world famous wedding photographer. I know she's laughing, but you know this is the fact. She is phenomenal at what she does, and it's been an honor to know her for quite a number of years, and it's fine.
A long time.
Yeah. DWF, and then now obviously through forums on Facebook and things like that. It's fantastic, and I've always followed your work, whether it's your blog or whether it's the ebooks that you've published in the past. They've all been just absolutely stupendous, absolutely wonderfully, wonderfully published. Today, you're launching a new website.
Yes.
The Dynamic Range.
Yes.
What a cool name!
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about the Dynamic Range. What is it all about?
Well, it's funny. I've wanted to blog for photographers for a really long time. And there's always sort of the debate of how much information do I put for photographers on my website that's geared towards actual wedding clients? Because after a certain point, you know, posting about doing things like Creative Live or posting about speaking engagements, it makes me look kind of cool to my clients. They look at it and they're like, oh, okay, other photographers want to learn from her. You know, she must be kind of neat. But then when you start putting too much on that site, then it starts to confuse clients. Like, well, wait a minute, is she a photography teacher or is she a wedding photographer? I don't understand. And because I am first and foremost a wedding photographer, I just didn't want to confuse anything. So then it just kind of got to be too much. I had a store for photographers on my wedding website, which I never liked because I thought that's just going to, clients aren't going to understand that.
Right.
And then I would sort of blog for photographers, but that felt kind of weird. And I always had in the back of my head, if I could just get this stuff off of my website, I could do more with it.
Sure.
And I always wanted to do more with it. Like, I wanted to interview people who ran conventions, and I wanted to do honest product reviews, because people, they do come to me and they're like, hey, do you use this thing? And what do you think about it?
Sure.
And I would think, wow, I'd really like to review that. But my clients don't want to read that. Like, they don't care.
Yeah.
So it sort of started coming together of, there was always a sentence in the back of my head of, if I had a blog for photographers, I could ... Mm-hmm. And then eventually I said, just stop talking about it. Like, you want to do a blog for photographers, just do a blog for photographers.
Sure.
So I had a new SusanStripling.com website with my friends over at Good Gallery. And when we were putting that together, we were talking about that little button on my site that says for photographers. And Rob Greer, who runs Good Gallery, kept saying, this is kind of dumb. Like, this is confusing. It's diluting your brand. Why don't we just take it off of there? I'm like, well, I can't just take it off of there. It's my store.
Mm-hmm.
So then the urge to really just stop talking about it and actually do it started up. And that was about 3-4 months ago. And in the middle of fall wedding season, I thought, hey, let me come up with this new business venture. That sounds like a great idea.
Indeed.
With all my spare time.
Absolutely.
So I just stopped sleeping. And it's amazing. You can get a lot done when you quit sleeping.
Indeed. Now, you told me before we started recording that you photograph some 50 weddings a year.
I do.
And so it just makes my heart leap out thinking you're able to produce a completely new website at the same time as photographing these weddings.
Yeah.
What's the deep desire to do this? Why are you doing this for photographers?
What are you doing? I realized actually Facebook made me realize that I needed to do this. People would ask me questions on Facebook and I would answer it. And then a couple of weeks later, someone else would ask me the exact same question. I would answer it.
Right.
And then I realized I've got this huge Facebook business page full of all of these questions and answers, and nobody knows where they are, and they're buried in all of these threads. And now every time I get a great question, let me just go put it over here somewhere else. Let me answer it in a place that eventually there will be a database of answers.
Absolutely.
Like when someone comes back and says, tell me more about off-camera flash, I can say, great, reference this post, and this post,
right,
complete with links of, like, this is where I got my stuff. And, you know, when I talk about these rogue flash vendors, where do you get them? Here's how you go get them.
Mm-hmm.
So I just kept thinking, you know, this is going to, it will be a resource. It will be a resource. And when I was new into photography, it would have been super helpful, the photographers that I looked up to go to one place, mm-hmm, and find kind of the advice that they dispensed for free,
sure,
all stored in one spot.
Right.
But then also, you know, if when I am doing these blog posts and these interviews and these product reviews and whatnot, yes, there is a store attached to the blog. And yes, I do hope people buy things from there. But the blog is also there for people to learn to trust me.
Sure.
Photographers who've never heard of me before, they're going to come hit a store.
Yep.
You're not going to buy a book from somebody that you don't know. You know, let me be a helpful resource to you. And if you ever desire more products, I hope that you'll keep me in mind for them. And if not, I hope that maybe you can find a product that works for you based on something that I recommended. So,
excellent.
You know, just trying to help, honestly.
Excellent. Excellent. You know, it's nice to hear that someone who does have such a busy schedule has also the passion to teach and to,
yes,
to really get people to really follow the right steps, the correct,
yes,
steps, I guess you'd,
yes,
call it. Now, you've also mentioned that you're teaching on Creative Live and you're leading,
yeah,
a fairly large group of people through a,
yeah,
mentoring
session.
Yeah, it's a
200-plus person group mentor session.
Fantastic. Wow.
Yeah, it's craziness. It's been going on for 2 months and it's,
yeah,
it ends in the middle of December. So it's been kind of a 3-month ride with these people and,
sure,
it's been very fun.
Indeed.
Very fun, actually.
And you've led workshops before, you know,
yes,
you've had your own workshops, and is the new website, the Dynamic Range, a place for you to invite people to maybe join you at those workshops?
Well, it's really interesting because there are so many methods of teaching now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's blogging, there's making videos online, there's online-led courses, there's things like Creative Live, and then there are still in-person workshops, which there's nothing that you can do online that's going to take the place of actually doing in-person learning.
Sure.
However, I haven't taught an in-person workshop in almost 2 years, and that's just, there are people who excel at doing in-person workshops, and I, you know, for people who've taken my workshops, I think I'm pretty okay at them, but it's not my favorite method of teaching.
Okay.
And also my husband has this workshop. He does this lighting and skill set boot camp out of his studio here in New Jersey. And nothing that I can ever do in person is going to be anywhere near what he does with these workshops. Like, they are so comprehensive that if anyone wants in-person learning, I just send them right over to Cliff because there's nothing better than what he's doing,
sure,
for that.
I've been to his workshop and it's a phenomenal
one. I mean, it's amazing,
it
right?
It is amazing. It is.
I've been to his workshop.
Yeah. He's an open book. I mean, that's one of the things I love about Cliff is like nothing is like secret. You know,
at
nothing
all.
Is like, this is my secret sauce. It's always like,
no.
I'm happy to tell you. And I think I get that feeling from your new website as well. It's going to,
yeah,
be all about just sharing and telling people,
yeah,
exactly how it is to be done.
The thing is, there are no secrets. Like,
exactly.
None of us are sitting over,
exactly,
here with these like magic bullets that we won't share with anybody.
Right.
You know, and the magic bullets are things that people don't want to hear. Like, why am I pretty good at wedding photography? I've been doing it 14 years.
Right.
Right? And I go out there and pound them out every,
exactly,
single year.
Right.
It's the magic bullet is experience and hard work and more hard work and, you know, being kind of insanely, relentlessly driven. So, and also not sleeping.
Indeed, indeed. I don't know how you do it because there's just so much that you do online that just blows my mind. Tell us a little bit about what's coming next for the Dynamic Range. I mean, you haven't even really launched yet, but I want to know, you know, what can one expect other than the blog posts, other,
yeah,
than the wonderful, beautifully designed ebooks.
Yeah.
You know, what is it? What else are you? What are your thoughts on in terms of offering photographers? What is your next
game
plan?
Well, I actually, you know, because I am relentlessly organized, I have about a 1 year business plan for it. And in my head, I know where I'd like it to be in 3, 5, 7, 10 years.
Wow.
I haven't gamed all that out. Like, let me get through the first year first. I have some courses in development, some self-study courses for photographers.
Excellent.
That I'm working on. That's my winter project because apparently, you know, I don't want to take time off this winter. I'm just going to keep on going. But, you know, what I have in the back of my head with it is, what are the questions that I have in my head about wedding photography and why is there no one place that I can go to get an answer to all of them? So it's getting all of the questions in my head out and in one place. Everything from, you know, the foolish questions that we ask each other, like, what shoes do you wear to a wedding? Right? Like, it sounds like such a little thing, but, you know, my back hurts if I don't wear the right shoes. It's kind of important.
Absolutely.
To what do you buy when you put together an off-camera flash? And what do you, you know, my friend Jen is going to write a column series for the blog that's like, how do I answer this? Right? Like when clients send you emails and you're like, oh my God, I have no idea how to write a nice answer to that. We're going to start putting together templates for you of, you know, when a client emails you and says, can I have more images? I just want more. Well, here's a good boilerplate response to start from.
Sure.
You know, I couldn't find anything like that when I was starting out.
Right.
So getting all of those things in my head of, you know, what are the little things that can help people out? And it's really comprised of a bunch of different things. There's product reviews, interviews. I've only got one up there right now, but I have about a million more in the pipeline. So product reviews, interviews, business tips, marketing tips. There's a series called Ask Me Anything, where you can email me in a question and I will answer it.
Awesome.
There's How Did You Do That, where I post a before shot of a room and then an after shot of what I did in the room.
I love those.
And show people how you get from A to B. I love those too.
I love those.
Because everyone has the misconception, and I mean, I get it, I guess, but everyone thinks that we all shoot these super fancy weddings at these super fancy locations.
Right.
And I try to explain, like, no, you can be in the Motel 6 and make a good image if you set it up correctly.
Sure.
So trying to show, like, this really cool ring shot happened in this room that looks like this.
Mm.
So on and so forth. And all of these things, just over time, continuing to develop them, continuing to make them more robust, continuing to add to that database of help me help you, just hopefully as the days, weeks, months, years go by, it will just become a good one-stop shop for, hey, I've got this question about wedding photography, whatever it might be, here's a place to go get an answer to it. And for me, it's nerve-wracking because I want to have all of that made. Like, I want to put it all out.
On day one, right?
Completely done on day one. But if it's going to be largely driven by the community and what the community needs, you have to let that guide you.
Absolutely.
So it's going to be pretty great. I'm really excited about it.
I'm hearing you say it's really for wedding photographers, but I'm thinking it's probably going to be for any photographer really who wants to get, you know, I mean, off-camera flash isn't like a wedding photographer.
It's not just for weddings, right? Exactly.
So things like that, I think there could be quite a bit of overlap with other genres of photography, which is.
Well, and there's also overlaps with other things as well, like. Facebook marketing is Facebook marketing, no matter who you are. And fine-tuning your social media is useful for anybody running a small business doing it all themselves. So, you know, I just, for the posts that I have out there now, I've got over 100 posts to come that are already written out. Write a post on this, write a post on this, write a post on this. So I'm really looking forward to getting all of this information out of my head, getting it all online, and getting it off of my photography website so that that experience stays very clean for prospective brides.
I think that's such an important takeaway for people listening in or watching this video, because I think I'm just as guilty of putting too many things in one spot and it muddies the water.
It does. Know? It confuses people.
Exactly. And you're thinking, they're going to love this, they're going to love that. No, they've come to you for one thing.
They're going to look at it and they're going to be like, I don't get it. Yeah. Why are you talking about an off, like, this just doesn't make any sense.
Right.
And I don't ever want my clients to think that I'm a teacher first and a wedding photographer second. And I don't want photographers to think that I'm a teacher first and a wedding photographer second, because first, I mean, I would be completely useless as a teacher to wedding photographers if I wasn't an actual working wedding photographer.
That's great.
And so just keeping these two businesses sort of separate. Now, there will still be a link to four photographers on my website, but now, you know, once this is up and running, it's just going to push you over to this much more robust thing than I could ever have on my wedding photography website.
Excellent. My last question to you is a bit of a curveball, Susan.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, come on.
How many years has Cliff been a photographer?
Cliff has been doing this for over 30 years.
Okay.
He started out doing photography in college.
In college, okay. So
Yeah, he was working for like a weekly paper when he was in college.
indeed. Background as a Philadelphia Inquirer photojournalist, I
Yes,
know.
he was.
The combined experiences between you and Cliff
Yes.
is about, I don't know, 45, 50 years
Yeah.
maybe, right?
Yeah, somewhere in there, yeah.
You must talk to each other and you must really wonder where things are going.
Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do, definitely.
What is happening with wedding photography
You
right
know, it's
now?
interesting,
What
and what I
troubles you more than anything else? What troubles you? I'm just curious to know, like, what is it that you guys go, oh my God, I can't believe this is happening, you know?
Yeah, what troubles me, and it's not universal, this is just a big generalization, is the difficulty of staying on top of the entitlement of the millennial generation. People wanting things now, they want it now. When they call you, they expect you to answer the phone every time. They want you to call them back immediately. They want you to be available to them on all accesses of all channels. And when the images are done, they want them right away. Like it's a very it's almost relentless. And the onslaught of all of the ways that you have to keep in touch and stay on top of things. You have to blog, you have to Facebook, you have to tweet, you have to Instagram, you have to do social media things that I don't even know about yet. Like it's so frantic
Right.
now in a way that is really kind of overwhelming. But what I'm seeing with the wedding industry, and this is just me observing, is I'm seeing the middle market really dropping out. A lot of people serving the high volume, low dollar market are doing great. And nothing wrong with that.
Sure.
That's a great thing. Would be a pretty brilliant second business, third business, fifth business. I don't have time for that right now. but the high volume, low dollar, like, listen, you know what you're getting. You're just going to get basic wedding photography. It's going to be $1,000. Go. Those people are doing really well. And the people on the, and I hate the word high end because what does that even mean? But the people that are kind of at the top of the game, sort of at a higher price tag, the luxury market of sorts,
Sure.
that's doing pretty well. But the middle market is kind of a disaster right now. Like people either want to cheap out or they're willing to jump up. It being in that mid ground is a hard place to be. But then on the flip side, staying above the mid ground is really hard. Like staying in the higher end of things, you just can't stop because there's a million people who want your place. So it's comforting to know that, okay, I'm in a pretty good place in a market that seems to be doing okay, but dear God, I've got to stay here. And that's kind of what keeps me up at night. And that's what keeps Cliff and I both up at night is how are my numbers this year compared to last year? And I keep a spreadsheet of I can tell you how many weddings I had booked for this year or last year at this time.
Wow.
And I just, if I can look at the numbers, they usually make me feel better, until sometimes they do the opposite. But I feel pretty good about where I am, but I don't know where that's going to be in a year. I don't know where the tides are going to turn or how the market is going to change or what if all of a sudden the middle is the new high and now the high end is gone? Like, what do I do? I hopefully will be glad that I've diversified my business. And
Absolutely.
also, I'm 36 years old. I can do 50 weddings a year. It's not joyous. Like, it's a lot of work and it's a lot of physical work. But there is going to be a point in time where I don't want to do 50 weddings a year anymore. And there always needs to be an exit plan. So
That's
we'll
awesome.
see. I'm sure we're going to do another one of these interviews in like 20 years, and I'm still going to be like, I've got 50 weddings a year. Because I can say I want to slow down, but please.
no comment from my end.
Yeah, we all know that doesn't really
No,
happen.
I know how I know how
My
absolutely.
kids have to, I have to send my kids to college. I can't
Yeah, absolutely.
stop.
Yeah, you got to put people to college, braces to put on,
Yeah,
on
and
the
then
kids.
one day I would
That's
like to
crazy.
retire one day, maybe. But
Sure.
for me, retirement will probably be 35 weddings a year instead of 50. So.
Wow, that's amazing. Your energy, I wish I had a fraction of. So, thank you so
It's
much
all
for
caffeine. It's all
it's all.
caffeine.
Yeah, hey, there you go. Whatever works, Susan. Whatever works. Susan, thank you so much. I'm so really thrilled to speak with you about the dynamic range. I know it's going to be an amazing thing for photographers, wedding photographers, portrait photographers. I don't care if you're a boudoir photographer, you're going to get something out
there's
of it.
Something out there for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I mean, there's going to be things out there for you where you're going to learn from somebody who's actually done it, is doing it, will be doing it for the next 35 years probably, you know. Right? I mean, it's just...
Let's be clear. Yeah. I mean,
yeah,
I'm in the wedding industry for life.
For life. Absolutely. And it's such a joy to speak with you because the energy you bring to anything, Susan, is really infectious. So thank you so much.
Thank you. And now I'm going to go blog.
There you go. Couple more blogs for your website.
I'll get a couple more up there. But, you know, it will be great. The more people that visit and the more people that engage, it will just allow me to continually tailor the content to what people need. And that's going to be great. So there's a Facebook page. I've got a Twitter account. You know, there are all of the ways for you to find me. So come find me.
Excellent.
I'm right here.
Thanks, Susan. Bye.
You're welcome. Bye.